as a term, because these guys are holding nothing back just yet.
Yeah, no, it's been super exciting, and we got a chance to play yesterday, and it's just really fun to sort of get into this environment. You know, it's something that we've seen in the movies, but we were actually in the gameplay, and with somebody here who has actually worked on the game. So let's talk more about what we're seeing here and getting into this, because there's three phases to this. So currently, we're in phase one.
That's right, and also we have some great game changers. You saw one of them pop up in just a little while. It was VF updates, Pool Shark, Moosel. We also have my boy Darkness, a.k.a. Dankness. He will be playing as well. We have Westy, Master G, Star Wars HQ, and some NBA Live, just cause. Why not? You know, just do your thing. But anyway, here you go. So Star Wars Battlefront 2, folks. Now, this is awesome because essentially phase one, you get to escort an MTT down the street of feed here, and the pressure is on for the clones. They have to hold back the assault here, Paul.
They do, definitely. The droids are sitting there trying to escort that MTT up the main pathway. If they're successful, we go on to that phase two. But right now, what we're seeing
nice
is some specialist gameplay from, I think, Battlefront updates.
Yeah, let's actually talk about the specialists. And also, you're going to see a couple different classes here. This class in particular that Massive G is using is the heavy class. Specialist, Connie or Sniper, right? But the
exactly.
Heavy class, what do they do here?
So the heavy class is great. They got a bit more health than your average trooper. They're also able to pop that combat shield, try to push into areas. So you can see those guys as pushers or defenders in some areas. But it looks like we got one of our vulture droids right now. Not sure who's flying this guy, but these guys are great at air-to-air, trying to take out those other ships that might be coming in, that Naboo N1 Starfighter. Otherwise, right. They're there to provide some great ground support like we're seeing here, trying to get some strafing runs in on those clones.
Oh, no!
Oh.
Come on, man.
You missed that tower.
You just did it wrong there, buddy.
So
sorry about that.
So it's great because we also do have the air support, but we also have ground support as well.
We do. So another thing that those air vehicles are great at is trying to take out some of the ground vehicles that you may see. The droid army has the AAT tank, something that's really great at troop suppression. But we see here a little clip of the V-Wing doing that. Oh, man, he's just mowing some droids down there.
Yeah, just absolutely shredding. You're going to see this happen quite a bit, especially in this phase, because there's a lot of open field here, right? And you can just come through for some great bombing runs, really, and eliminate as many people as you possibly can. And also, you put the presence of an air vehicle out there. Players will fear the skies, and they will, you know, look for cover in this map, where it's already difficult to find cover to begin with in this phase in particular.
Absolutely. And you can see right now that there is an AAT tank sitting around on the battlefield. He is probably taking out those clone troopers, but this vulture droid is really stepping it up.
What I love about this is everyone's like, oh, look at this great open map. And then when you start phase two, it's like everything starts coming in and coming way closer together. And we're
Absolutely.
Talking a little bit more about the assault class. So for somebody who has just started playing this, never played any previous versions, do you feel like the assault class might be something perfect for them to pick up?
I think the assault class is yes, absolutely. It's something that is, that's painful. The assault
That's
class is something
hurt.
That a lot of players will be able to jump right into. They're your frontline flanker attacker. I think they're going to be fairly easy. You can get right in and just start having, you know, your typical run and gun action. Their signature ability, you see here at the top of the screen, your number two ability, that switches you over to a shotgun. You get a little bit faster, and you're able to really get in there and kind of, you know, break through those front lines.
Oh, I love it. I love using the shotgun, man. It is so good. And it's actually, when I first used it, it really caught me off guard. I wasn't expecting it. And I said, wait a minute. I could destroy people with it. So I just charged into the room and just absolutely shredded everyone. It was so fun to play with here. We're also seeing some great
dogfighting
here between the clones and the separatists. This is certainly what a lot of folks love in Star Wars, and just really in any game that DICE makes, right? They just always do a good job with the air combat. He's really trying to track him down. This vulture's
really
tough.
He's not having much luck.
Yeah, that vulture cannot shake him.
Well, so we got Star Wars HQ here. You know, he's playing the assault class again, and you saw here that he has the signature thermal detonator that he'll be able to kind of suppress some of those guys with as he rushes in.
And there are different weapons as well. Like one of the guns that I would oftentimes use was the semi-automatic gun. It, you know, fired a lot slower, but you can get some great shots with it. And then there's also this nice, compact, SMG style, blaster that really shreds through people in close range. I was, you know, using a little.
I mean, we want to give you a little bit more weapon variety this time around, you know?
Yeah.
Also, some AAT tank action here, and this is that doing what it does best. You're suppressing that point, trying to keep those clones out of the way.
They're trying to make their way forward as the objective continues to march down. He has to get away from that.
I don't know. Is he trying to flank the tank? That's not smart.
I don't know, man. Maybe he will.
Oh, you saw a little combat roll there. Got to give you some escape options in case you get into some hairy action.
Uh-oh, we didn't get to see this one before. Finally.
Oh, we haven't.
Some ATRTs, yes. So these are great for taking out those AATs. So these guys are a little quick. They have an ion charge ability. That way they'll be able to do a little bit more extra damage against the tank should they see it. So you can imagine like three or four of these on the battlefield really rushing around points. Like, look at this.
Can you stop someone
through.
Out? What can you do with this?
You can run someone over if you want.
I was actually going to say, could I get shot off of it if I'm on top of it because my body's exposed? That question was answered, you know, instantly.
Almost immediately.
Almost immediately. Oh, man. So, Mr. Muselk here, you know, look for this guy to be on a tear a little bit later as well. And also, I did want to highlight, we had an officer, as a matter of fact, right in front of Star Wars
HQ. We did,
HQ
one of my
there.
Favorite classes.
What is it about the officer that makes it so unique?
I mean, my Twitch skills aren't where they used to be. I'm
Fair.
A bit slower nowadays. But I'm able to really buff up my class, or buff up my teammates, try to let them get some extra health, let them push through the points faster. And,
what happened there?
Finally, some good dogfighting going in there.
Okay,
so
all right. What's
great about some of these starfighters is these are accessed through our new battle point system. So instead of finding a pickup token on the map like we used to in the last game, you're now able to, depending on how well you do, whether you're scoring points via kills, via team play assists, or you're playing the objective like we really want players to do, you're earning points continuously that will allow you to spend those on whether it be a special character, whether it be a vehicle, or even a hero.
So and the battle points, that allows you to unlock all of those things.
All those things, definitely.
And also something to look out for, too. When we get into phase two, that's when battle points are really going to play a role there, right?
I mean, right now, definitely, you see a lot more. It's an open space. You have time for this air combat and some vehicle gameplay. But once we get inside, it's going to be a different story.
That's right. Things are definitely going to heat up. And what is this happening, right? This is a lock-on just trying to shake him out?
Yep.
Yeah,
nice.
They better enjoy their air combat here, because that's not going to be happening for much longer.
Oh, Master Chi is just destroying him. He got picked off. Nice job.
But he was doing what he needed to do, support his team, right? It's that combined arms fire. You want to make sure that somebody's trying to cover you from the air.
Oh, boy. So, and you can see after every respawn as well, you get those
how many points you're earning.
Right?
That's right.
So you can use those later on. Got some specialist gameplay here as well. Maybe you can take off a couple faces, perhaps. That
and so in the specialist class, you can also deploy different types of traps as
well. Yeah, absolutely. So they have access to a trip mine. So if you want to sit there and you want to be, you know, that true sniper character, you set up some trip mines behind yourself, make sure nobody can flank you. But really, you're there to provide some of that cover fire for your troops downrange. And it's especially potent in this area because it is such a big open area. So that specialist will really shine in phase one.
Some more bombing runs here and just absolutely tearing them up. I have to say, man, Muselk is killing it. Killing it in this world.
Again, he's doing great. Oh, and we see there one of the officer classes right next to one of the clones.
Officer is fantastic for pushing, right? You want to be able to push the objective.
Definitely.
Support your team. Like, if you are playing with your buddies, you want to be able to have at least one officer available because he keeps you going in the fight.
At least. I mean, they really help push, you know, when those heavies are trying to drive towards a point, you got your officers behind you, giving you some extra health, making sure that you're still able to complete that push. Or on the opposite side, if you're one of the droids and you really need to lock down a point, the officers have access to a turret that they can place on the ground and, you know, give you a little bit more fire support for that area.
I'm trying to see if Massive G here is, you know, he's really focused on the bombing runs, right? He's not trying to go into combat with Muso, who's up there. There's Darkness 429. Just shredding everyone up here. Maybe he can get a couple kills.
He just went into siege mode?
Yeah, this is happening.
Oh, yeah, so tell us about the siege mode. How does this play out?
In siege mode, for a limited time, you're able to just blow up some huge area effect shots. You lock down your position, but you're able to have a lot more firepower.
We also just saw the B2 super battle droid there as well. That's something you can get
another
with
one
battle
of my favorites.
Points as well.
Another one of my favorites. Yeah, you can grab those guys via the battle point system. Those guys, great at pushing points again. Where they have high health, a lot of rapid fire. Oh!
Here we go.
Oh, there it is.
And this big explosion indicates phase one is over. Now we start phase two. And this is when the action really begins to pick up here because it gets really tight inside of that building and players need to be mindful of that and look for this B2 to just shred through everyone, especially with that cooling ability that he has to be able to keep him just constantly shooting in the fight.
He's gonna make a huge difference here as the fight moves inside. I mean, there's gonna be narrow pathways. He's gonna be able to just shred as soon as anybody gets in his way because it's those narrow corridors. It's gonna be trouble.
And just waiting for the prime opportunity to push up here. Claire's falling. Got you know white boy there.
Here we go. Some Darth Maul action.
Here we go, folks.
This is where it starts to get interesting.
This is scary.
Darth Maul will excel in phase two and phase three as you're inside. I mean, he's a great mobile attacker. He's going to sit there with his lightsaber.
Close quarters too. So he's absolutely perfect for that.
Absolutely. I mean, some of his abilities you can see here. He's got that spin attack. He's able to just rush in and out of combat and just take guys out in the process.
It was funny, I was talking to Musa earlier, and he was using Darth Maul, and he was saying how there's Boba Fett as well. But he was talking about how he wishes Darth Maul could reflect. I was like, if he could reflect, he'd be too strong.
He'd be way too strong.
Oh, there goes Boba Fett.
That was a good flank by Boba Fett and Maul. Just shredded the clone army, unfortunately.
What role does Boba Fett fill in this battle?
Boba Fett is definitely a hunter-killer. So if the clone army is able to get some of their heroes in play, like this is where Boba Fett will really shine. With that jetpack of his, he's able to kind of float above the battlefield, fire off some rockets, and really just take out an individual target.
So what difference does he have from the last game?
From the last game, we've given him a bit new tricks. He's got a new concussion rocket that will really disorient players completely. But he also has this rocket barrage instead of just one rocket. He's able to really just lay down his suppressive fire.
Nice. Also, one thing to keep in mind, we saw the B2, here we go, but on the clone side, you know, there are specialist characters that you can pick up as well. We haven't seen much of it yet, but that would be the clone jump trooper.
That's right.
Very different from the standard like assault class or heavy class. It has the jump jets that you love from Battlefront, the original.
That's right.
Brought back here, but now focused on the central class.
Exactly.
Yeah, we're back to Boba Fett here with the rocket jumps.
He's shredding through.
He will just lay down so much firepower. It's intense.
Oh, they got him though. Jesse was able to find him on that one, but here comes some officer gameplay here.
Oh, good. Finally, somebody playing some support.
Support people matter, too.
They do. You gotta give them some love. We're the linchpin of the team, you know?
Yeah, exactly. Now, what is his 2 exactly? His 2 is the healing
ability? His 2 ability is that, yeah, exactly. It's that healing ability. It gives you a little bit of buff for your little over health, but it also heals you back up. So it's, oh, we got some of the jump troopers.
Oh boy, and here we go. It's getting ready for phase 3 in just a little bit. There's a jump trooper. We talked about him before. Jump trooper, super fun to play. But again, you know, it's attached to a specialist now, so not everyone's going to have it equipped, although it was really fun in the original Battlefront.
That's right.
But I am going to be excited to hop into jump trooper and shred people myself.
I mean, I know a lot of people love the jump pad. Oh, jeez!
Oh, now we've got Rey! Oh. Not going to lie, I'm super excited to play as her.
She's quite a powerful character.
Don't run!
She got out of that one really quickly.
But they got her. The droid! Fallen by a
Finished
simple droid.
No, but Rey
so
has,
how does her
Rey has
mind trick affect enemies?
Absolutely. So Rey's mind trick is something that against all enemies, they'll be confused for a little bit, and your controls will kind of work against you, making you a little bit more vulnerable to attack.
Just so you guys know, this is when it gets insane. Because there's so much going on here. And was that a little Han?
We saw a little Han, yeah.
Are we going to get some Han?
I hope so.
I hope so.
But I mean, you saw it earlier. So every time you finish a life, we'll show you how many battle points you have. And some people have enough points to get those reinforcements. And especially this late in the game, you'll see a lot more of these special classes coming out, a lot more of the heroes coming out. So again, this jump trooper here, you know, with his rocket launcher and his jump pack, trying to be mobile, trying to fly into that last zone and capture a point.
This is really where heavies are going to thrive as well because
my goodness, you just see him laying down fire
through the doorway, just absolutely dominating the clones. They need to push out.
They need to fight
this one out here. There are so many lives left that the Separatists have to their team. They could really run through this. The clones have to start acting fast because if they cap it, that will be it. The Separatists will win this game.
It's not looking so good for my boys in the clone army.
I'm a Separatist fan. So I'm excited.
I'm just going to go on whichever team wins.
Oh, okay.
So
okay.
I'm not going to be too picky here.
Okay, you can jump and ship. I understand that. You know, no loyalties. Maybe you are Sith after all.
Ooh. Maybe I am.
Oh, who knows?
Shots fired.
Yeah, so in this third phase, though, in the droids are trying to capture that throne room. So you can see here, if you remember, this is the main throne.
And this is such super close quarters. Do you have any like sort of strategies that you would?
Absolutely.
Know,
I mean, if you're the clones, you're hoping that. Oh, geez.
Han Solo's just getting torn up.
This is gonna be trouble.
It's like too soon, man. I can't relive Force Awakens again. You know, like don't do it.
Darth Maul is just destroying absolutely everything.
Everything.
I mean, is there any tips to like taking him down?
I mean, you want to try to combined arms fire.
Oh.
The tip is blasters.
Run away. Maybe run away.
Run away and just shoot the crap out of Darth Maul. Oh man.
He was our MVP. Look at that.
Nice stuff. Moose out. Congratulations.
36 kills.
Avenge our emperor.